them on blazeradioonline.com.
I mean, like, come on! How hard is it to come up with a real podcast idea these days?
Welcome, true believers.
Welcome to 4-on-4, where we have four experts on the four major sports. Join Sammy Newt, Dylan Wickman, Justin DeHaas, and Sean Brennan on Blaze Radio as they break down an exciting semester of sports that includes the beginning of hockey and basketball, the heart of the NFL and college football seasons, the MLB playoffs, and much more. At the end of the day, we're just four roommates that love to talk sports, so join the conversation. Listen live on blazeradioonline.com every Friday at noon, or if you missed us, check us out on Spotify where you can hear all of our shows.
To all who come to this happy place, welcome. If you're looking for intellectual debates on Marvel topics, you may be in the wrong place.
Jesus, when I bought Marvel, I didn't think three guys were going to make a stupid podcast about it.
That's right. It's time for Agents of Blaze. Every Sunday at 8:30 p.m. on blazeradioonline.com.
I mean, like, come on! How hard is it to come up with a real podcast idea these days?
Welcome, true believers.
So here they are, the best group in the universe, musician for musician, the dynamic, electronic, Grateful Dead.
I agree. They are the best group in the universe. And if you also agree, or even if you don't, you should tune into my show, Back from the Dead, every Monday night at 8 p.m., only on Blaze Radio, on blazeradioonline.com. Peace and love, everyone. Jam with you on Monday.
Jacob Jones. Ben Yates. Yeah. The Valley Variety, live every Thursday at 4 p.m. on Blaze Radio.
Did you know that this inspired this?
Here's to the ones that we got.
Or that this inspired this? Tune in to Classically Trained as I, Jake Brown, will dissect how classical music has influenced music of today. Every Friday at 4 to 5 p.m. only on Blaze Radio.
This is Edward Van Halen.
Hi, I'm Jerry Garcia.
Hi, I'm Stevie Nicks.
Hey, I'm Vince Neil.
What up, dudes? I'm Tommy Lee.
And we're Motley Crue.
Hello, out there. This is George Harrison.
David Lee Roth from Van Halen here.
Hi, it's me, the great and powerful Cher.
Hi, I'm Anna Snow. And you may not know my name yet, but if you like all of those people, or any of them, you should tune into my show, Currently Spinning, right here on Blaze Radio, on blazeradioonline.com, every Wednesday at 3 p.m. Don't forget to tune in and rock on.
Get up with East Coast Bias every Monday morning on Blaze Radio at 11 a.m. every single Monday. Dylan Pescatore will take you through every single sport, what's happened the past week. We go from balls to rackets, anything in terms of sports, we have you covered. On Blaze Radio, East Coast Bias, the name of the show, hosted by Dylan Pescatore, every single Monday morning, 11 a.m.
Right, it's game number 4 of 5 in our ASU Invitational. Today we will see number 12 UCSB against 19th ranked San Jose State. Welcome on into the broadcast booth, Aiden Blank and Blake Neiman. Oh boy, we're still rolling 4 games in, and this can be a fun one. We get our second top 25 duel of the day. Two teams that have lost to ASU but gotten wins otherwise in this tournament. Or rather, not San Jose State, but UCSB did get a win otherwise in this tournament. San Jose State still looking for their first win of the weekend.
Yeah, San Jose State played pretty competitively with ASU for the early going. Sun Devils did separate a bit late, but then UCSB also a loss to the Sun Devils on Friday, but were able to bounce back in dominant dominant fashion over Ottawa, Arizona this morning, but these two teams seem very neck and neck, and it should be a very good match.
Again, San Jose State comes in 19th in the nation. They were able to hang around with ASU. They certainly have a lot of momentum if they can keep that energy up to play a real good game, maybe get a win today.
Yeah, the Spartans are hungry. Five straight losses, looking to bounce back and get in the win column, while UCSB looking to build on their big win this morning and get a top 20 victory.
Let's take a break. We're back in just a bit with our ball game number four here on Blaze TV.
Welcome to 4-on-4, where we have four experts on the four major sports. Join Sammy Newt, Dylan Wickman, Justin DeHaas, and Sean Brennan on Blaze Radio as they break down an exciting semester of sports that includes the beginning of hockey and basketball, the heart of the NFL and college football seasons, the MLB playoffs, and much more. At the end of the day, we're just four roommates that love to talk sports, so join the conversation. Listen live on blazeradioonline.com every Friday at noon, or, if you missed us, check us out on Spotify, where you can hear all of our shows.
Back at Mona Plummer Aquatic Center with Blake Neiman, I'm Aiden Blank. Great to be with you. It's our fourth game of the day, Blake. And again, our second time seeing each of these two teams. The Devils and the Gauchos. All set for battle. Game number four, the final game for each of these teams today. We'll have ASU and Marist coming up later on to close out the day. And then a whole slew of games tomorrow. But for now, we're going to sit back, enjoy this top 25 matchup. The first one we saw was pretty darn good.
Yeah, first one was great. And then now we're going to get these two teams against each other. Had to face the gauntlet in terms of ASU. They're going to have to try and respond from that. Get themselves back on track.
These teams set in their own end lines, ready to rock. Game number four of the day. San Jose, UC Santa Barbara coming in now at 8-4 with that win over Ottawa earlier. San Jose State 1-4 on the season. Boy, would they like to get a win. It'd
be great to get a win. For San Jose State and UCSB, both of them looking for a win.
Oh, physicality right off the bat. San Jose State wins the toss into the pool. They are on offense first. Didn't look totally overmatched by ASU. They were able to keep track and keep it within three, four goals most of the night.
Yeah, able to stick with
the day, rather.
Stick with the Sun Devils, yeah.
Up the near sideline they come. San Jose State are in the blue caps, the dark blue with that white lettering. Numbers in the white is UC Santa Barbara. Those very similar color schemes that will be certainly interesting to keep track of on the day. Darcy Spark all the way up to the top for Renee Fleming. Lofted inside and just out of the grip of Katie Kelly. She had a good look if she had been able to corral it, but well, she was a step ahead and turns the ball over for UCSB. Gaucho is working on offense now. Their head coach, Cyrilla Kay, trying to lead them to their eighth victory of the season. Great turnaround, but an even better save by Raffin and net. See if San Jose State goes with two goalies again. They did make a switch in the midway point of the matchup against ASU, but did finish with Raffin. She was their starter and closed the game once it got really close, so that kind of shows you where they lie depth-wise. Macon Pardon up top for Fleming. Throws it, and it's clamped down by Dunleavy. Under 6 minutes to play. We're just getting warmed up in this top 25 battle. Two of them today. This is the second. Towards the corner we go. Juju Amaral rises and fires at a great stop.
Both goalies showing off their prowess.
Absolutely.
Right now. We haven't seen many games to where it's been no score.
Yeah.
Through the first 3 minutes of the game, is either one has set the tone or the other. But as we said, this is going to be a tight. Both of these teams are very similar in another and how they are lined up in the schemes that they go with.
We haven't really seen a lot of sequences today in which 3 minutes went by without a goal, but we're 30 seconds from getting just that.
Looks like it's going to be a timeout by San Jose yep. State and try and reset that scoring momentum.
Going to keep it here as we move along on a sometimes gorgeous, sometimes gloomy Saturday. We'll take a look at those top 25 rankings mentioned. Where these two teams lie, Arizona State right at the top of that heap, number 7 in the nation. But all four teams in Division I that are here this weekend at least receive some votes in the poll. The one team that didn't is the NAIA defending national champions.
So much competition.
Stacked field.
Stacked field is the way to put it. Lots of great competition in the pool this weekend.
Into the corner, back up top. Here's Plotz, throws it in. Oh, a wedgie. The first goal of the game in dramatic style. 5:17 left, and the Spartans set the tone, leading 1-0, their first lead of this tournament.
Yeah, great shot there by the Spartans. Able to get on the board first. And just as we were saying, low scoring, not so much. They wipe away all of that and reset with the timeout. Great reset by Beth Harberts. Knew that her team needed to get some readjustment, and they did just that.
Right around mid-pool, UCSB will try to come back on the attack. San Jose State played the closest game we've seen today. That was against ASU. Now they're trying to get a win, come away with a victory on this, their first day of competition, the second day technically of this Invitational. Over on the far side, looking for help. Look at that defense. San Jose State certainly held their own defensively with Arizona State. Well, they're starting to get the upper hand here as time continues to tick in the first.
Starting to show off that defensive side of their game in addition to their offensive success on that last possession.
Work down towards the net, 19 to shoot. Lofted inside and taken away. We've seen a lot of aggressive goalkeeping today. Right there, UCSB gets some with Ava Donlevy. The best goalies we've seen today have been the ones that are aggressive, that come out and take it and apply a little bit of defensive pressure themselves.
Yeah, I think you're alluding to Inaz Sanchez for Maris, sure, who is one of the best at doing just that. So you're starting to see that similar strategy with the other elite goalkeepers in this tournament.
Turnaround shot slides out with 4:12 on the timer. Sun Devils are coming up later on. They'll face the Maris Red Fox. Is stopped in front, stood up, another one lofted towards the net, and retrieved by Donlevy. Wow.
Yeah, you see Donlevy, we were just talking about it, going out and addressing the point of attack and not letting the Spartans get in deep.
Here come the Spartans on the attack. Mullane, Christine Mullane, fires it up top for Cammie Mross. Now Mullane again, lets one fly, and it rocks the crossbar. 3:25 in the period. Spartans on top, but just by a goal, warming things up here from Tempe. 3:13 on the timer. San Jose State's gotten some good looks close to the net. You don't want to make that a habit. And this is going to be a restriction. Or an exclusion, rather. It's going in favor of San Jose State. Can they get their first multi-goal lead of the day? We're going to find out with 20 to shoot. Fired up top for Spark. Onto the net it goes, and a great stop. Plots with a rip, but it's rejected. It will give San Jose State a new shot clock, though. They're still on the power play. Over for Fleming. Rotated back up top, Plots towards the corner. Here's Anderson Vallela. Referee signaling it will stay with San Jose State, but the power play comes to an end. Gauchos kill their first of the day.
Great job by the Gauchos showing off that defense. That's the key, keeping them on the perimeter, not letting them get inside. That was how San Jose State got their first goal of the day.
There's a foul. Another restriction coming up. Second power play of this possession for San Jose. 20 to trigger. Back up top, look it, fires high. So back-to-back power plays killed off by the Gauchos. That's not something we've seen a lot from anybody today. The power play's been really effective for everyone.
Absolutely, and great job by the Gauchos. Now have to take advantage and convert it into some offense.
Transition ball, McKay. Here's Ferguson. And now Mullane. Trying to find that shot. 120 seconds remaining in the period. And another stop by San Jose State. It's been an iron wall for them defensively. Spartans on the move, 149 in the period. Here's Fleming. Renee Fleming over for Ivana Anderson Vallela out of La Paz, Mexico, a grad student. And another one fired high, just some wild shots early in this game. .128 to play, first quarter. We're back the other way. See what they can do. Oh, a long outlet. Up ahead, all alone, Lucchesi. Can she finish? No, she stood up. Lucchesi gets stopped by Dunleavy. Now the Gauchos trying to build a little momentum in transition themselves. And a foul committed by Plotz. Both of these goalies taking center stage. 25 seconds on the shot clock, 57 on the game clock. Moved over and back around for Cammy Ross. Inside. Oh, and a spike! Amani Clemens! What a finish at the net! We're tied at one.
It was only bound for Amani Clemens to be the person to bat at home. She's the centerpiece that revolves for UCSB. Two goals in the game against ASU and is able to respond with the first of the day for the Gauchos.
Amani spikes it ferociously. She's not even one of our players to watch. Get a look at Renee Fleming. We saw her earlier for San Jose State. And Darcy Spark, the freshman, has quite literally been the spark for this team so far. Fleming. Over for Spark. Our players to watch getting involved on this possession. Inside 10 to shoot. Down to 6. Spartan's got a hand on it. Looks like an exclusion. No, it was just a plain foul. 10 left in the period. 8 to go to the corner. Trying to get an angle, bounces it through! Renee Fleming uses the angle to her advantage. Only a 3-goal period as it stands. And two of them have gone to the Spartans.
Low scoring battle back and forth.
3 seconds, long shot. Clubbed by Don Levy, and that is how the period comes to an end. Well, that's about as good a quarter as we've seen all day. We thought the ASU San Jose State game was the bar. This might be different. This has been as good a defensive battle as you could get.
Both these teams hungry for a win, hungry to build off of what they've built so far. And man, a top 20 matchup that has lived up to every bit of it.
Let's take a break. We're back in 2.5 minutes. San Jose State and UCSB 2-1 in favor of the Spartans here on Blaze TV.
Hi everybody, I'm Ben Paris. Basically, you took an extra movie and an extra however many amount of years to get the exact same result.
I did not expect for Pete Davidson to somehow make me feel better about this entire situation.
If I've learned one thing in my life, it's to simply be yourself. Tune into Just Be Ben, the Ben Paris Show, for a little bit of everything, Tuesdays at 3 on BlazeRadioOnline.com.
ASU are your conference champions!
Welcome to What You're Talking About, the official show of the Arizona State ACHA D1 Women's Hockey Team.
Score! It's not through! Sam Murphy breaks the ice!
From big moments in big games...
Score! There's a hat-trick for Sydney Poston!
...to breaking news and interviews.
What? Use one word to describe your feelings right now.
Ecstatic, honestly.
It's all covered here at 8:30, every Friday morning by team reporter Chase Beardsley and play-by-play announcer Trey Matthews, as the WWCHL champions look to defend their title. So make sure to tune in to hear what we're talking about.
Death to the Pac-12. In what is the last year we will likely ever see Pac-12 football, the conference is the strongest it has ever been and the best in the nation. I'm your host, Devin Henderson, and we'll be joined by co-host Blake Neiman on our show, Never Lacking in the Pack. Until the final whistle blows on the conference, stay up to date every week with weekly analysis, predictions, stories, trivia, and everything you need to never get caught lacking in the pack. Join us every Tuesday, 2:30 to 3 p.m., as we break down all you need to know in the beloved Conference of Champions here on BlazeRadioOnline.com.
Do not attempt to adjust your radio. There is nothing wrong.
We have taken control as to bring you this special show. We will return it to you as soon as you are grooving.
Every Friday from 2 to 3 here on The Blaze, get your groove adjusted with the generational music trauma experience.
Turn your ears on and tune out as we take you down the river of musical knowledge, sending deep cuts, underground artists, and unnecessary stories your way.
If you dig that groove, listen to the Generational Music Trauma Experience Fridays 2 to 3 on Blaze Radio.
Welcome back. We're ready for second quarter action here in our top 25 duel between San Jose State and UC Santa Barbara. Aiden and Blake, great to be with you. Mr. Neiman, your takeaways from that first quarter.
I would say I was very impressed by the UCSB defense and the way they were able to keep it together. Although the Spartans were able to trickle through a couple of times, there were some very tough possessions that UCSB was able to pester off. And for me, it's centered around the goalkeeper and Ava Donlevy. She has been very impressive so far in this match.
Second time that both of these teams have played today, but you wouldn't know it. They both look very well rested and trained. Good rip to start the period, but it's going to clank off near iron.
Nice shot by JoJo Shear. Two-time All-State honoree in California in high school.
7:30 left. Santa Barbara on defense for the first time. You mentioned how impressed you were with their stop. Five to shoot. They got her trapped. What a great start for the defense. First throwaway that we've seen.
That's what I'm talking about. The perimeter defense is superb.
Getting down to 7 minutes in this first half. The sun's starting to shine here on Mona Plummer Aquatic Center. We've seen Sun Devils swim and dive here. Sun Devil water polo hoping. Oh, did that cross the line? It did. Wow. Rang the bell and trickled in. 6:45 to play. And we're all knotted up at two apiece.
Just like that. UCSB, with the transition from defense to offense, they're starting to find what San Jose State found during that early first going and be able to transition that play.
We could have reviewed it. We'll get our shot. 6:30 in the half. Looking for a lob inside. And out comes the goalie, Ruffin. Or rather, that's Donlevy, who once again shows her aggressiveness. Stops the play cold in its tracks. We've seen fans start to trickle in, especially now that the rain has subsided and it's gotten a little warmer. Good rip. Got a piece of spark. San Jose State coming back on the attack. Harassed right around mid-pool. Zorio comes away with it. Thrown inside for Ruzic. And Ruzic gets hacked. Going towards the end line. 18 to shoot. Azorio looking, shooting, and saved. Oh, Donlevy. Just an absolute machine at the net. San Jose State will try to get another one past her. There's a reason that they've only gotten two so far. But remember, they had this kind of slow start in that first game as well against ASU. And it didn't end like that. They were moving offensively by the end of that ASU game. 5:19 left, 12 to shoot. Loft inside and trapped up against the crossbar. Donlevy, another save.
Donlevy and her wingspan, her reach, just the way she is spreading her body, moving it across the net, absorbing that area and not allowing any penetration.
Moving towards the corner, lofted back up. Spark. Rotated here, Amaral thrown away. San Jose State has kind of under the radar been just as good defensively. They've not had a lot of shots come on net. One up for Azorio.
It's kind of a Marist style to where they haven't let them in as deep as UCSB has. But there's a reason that Don Levy was an All-American nominee.
Under 15 to go, 11 to shoot. And a turnover.
And you know, she's a hockey fan. Wonder if she knows Sun Devil hockey.
Who doesn't know Sun Devil hockey? Here's Easter in front, and another stop.
What a great game we have right now. 2-2, this is the best game we've had so far today. It's very tight, neck and neck.
Scoring.
This is a great water polo.
Lob up top. Tracked down by Spark, doubled, and they take it away.
Yeah, these double teams really playing a factor here for UCSB. Teamwork makes the dreamer, man.
Yeah, that's the thing that kind of makes water polo so much different. Great defense there around mid-pool. Is that, I mean, the double teams, you know, you can get out of one in any other sport. You get doubled in water polo, it is hard to get out of that. A loft inside, this should result in an exclusion. Off goes Azorio, great chance for UCSB. Oh, it's off the top corner. Just missed it. Camilla McKay, great look. San Jose State avoids surrendering their first lead of the day.
Yeah, the Spartans haven't trailed. That's a good point. UCSB, though, it seems like they have a little bit of the momentum moving in their direction.
Working towards the net. Spark, tightly defended. UCSB, you can tell, did their homework. They know which players can be a problem with the Spartans. They know who is able to keep them in that game with ASU, and they've shut them down.
Absolutely. Take players out of the game. I mean, think about it in ASU terms. You look at players like Petra Party, the coach that she's been able to accumulate, some of those key factors like Sophie Shoulder Robinson. If you take some of those key factors out of the game, it really eliminates the offense.
Towards the corner, Flynn, Aiden Flynn. Back up top, skipped against the water and saved. Lee Leiter gave it a good look. Tatiana Roffin, so strong in the net.
Hometown hero in that net.
Out of San Jose. Only one on the roster that is, the exception of Genevieve Larkin. Under 10 to shoot. Spartans looking for the lead, and they get it.
Looks like Don Levy got a little caught off guard. There's some whistles.
Yeah. I think they might have called the goal off. They've marked it on the scoreboard as 3-2. But asked for some substitutions.
Beth Harberts is calling some of her players over to the side. So the goal does not count. We just heard it over
called the
PA
goal
system.
Off. And we resume play.
Yeah, it looks like Don Levy was really caught off guard by that. Because you normally don't see her let a ball just go past like that.
Exactly. No kind of movement at all. Lofted inside by Amaral. They get it back to Juju. At the top. And underneath, it looked like Lee Leiter went under the pool for a minute. But before that, there was a foul, and there will be an exclusion when we come back. 1:46 to play, and a 2-2 ball game. We're getting a good defensive showcase here in game number four here at the ASU Invitational on Blaze TV.
For new episodes of In This Movie, where I attempt to explore how these favorite characters of ours make us feel.
Hypothetically speaking, if we were to talk about news,
politics,
entertainment,
pop culture,
sports,
business,
would you listen? Well, you can.
Tune in to Hypothetically Speaking
every Tuesday night at 5 on Blaze Radio on blazeradioonline.com
with your hosts, Maddie Fries, Lydia Curry, and Zach Bradshaw.
Bye.
I like sports journalism. I like the sports industry. I like all my classes. I just want to build connections, you know?
Oh my God, did you just say you wanted to pick the brains of like the sports industry's finest once a week and just learn all the ins and outs of the sports industry and build relationships and build connections for your future endeavors?
Yeah, are you serious?
Oh yeah, happy Sunday fun day. Every Sunday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. tune in to How To Sports with Austin Scott, Jeffrey Hinkle, and Hayden Silly, where we interview the sports industry's finest, we pick their brains, we get advice, and we do it all. Tune in. How To Sports, best sports industry show on Blaze Radio.
Tired of hearing that sound, looking down at your bracket in disgust, and crumpling it up? Us too, but we're here to help. Tune into Heat Check every Wednesday night at 9 p.m. on BlazeRadioOnline.com as Kevin Mulator, Scott Sanduli, Ryan Sikora, and Riley Swenson cover all things college basketball to have you well prepared by March to win that bracket pool and brag to your friends. So act now before it's too late and that bracket is busted.
Welcome back to the Mona Plummer Aquatic Center. A gorgeous day in Tempe, Arizona. We're back underway here on Blaze TV. San Jose State and UC Santa Barbara. Lucy Mazuski up top. A shot, and another one that rings the bell. Great stop by San Jose. Flynn tried to put it home. Spartans in transition. Good look, and just wide. Spartans have been oh so close to taking the lead again, Blake. They've been back and forth, but they haven't been able to find the back of the net, and the one time they did, it was called off.
Yeah, I mean, the momentum has clearly swayed toward UCSB over these past few minutes and are going to try and take their first lead here in the offensive zone.
Here come the Gauchos trying to get their first lead of the day. Lofted inside and immediately stopped.
Looks like
but the whistle will keep it with us. Santa Barbara off the exclusion on a power play. On the foul.
Lots of communication going on.
Yep. On a power play, the Gauchos with 35 seconds left in the period.
Great deflection there by Lucy Mizuweski.
24 on the clock and 5 on the shot clock, and a shot bounces into the hands of Tatiana Rafin at the net for San Jose.
San Jose, no allow of that penetration inside.
It's their first kill of an exclusion. 5 to go. 3 to go in the half. One more shot here. Oh, we're gonna get a penalty at the very end here. Here's your chance. San Jose State sending Mizuweski to the line. 3 seconds left in the quarter. Stopped at the net. She's stood up by Dunleavy. What a finish. And she puts a charge into this crowd as we go to break.
What a finish. How about that? A free shot opportunity at the end of the quarter. And there you go. Aren't able to capitalize. That was a crucial moment for San Jose State. But again, we stay posted at 2 apiece.
Mizuweski was the closest to getting a goal for San Jose State in those final few minutes. 2-2, how about that for a score? As we go into break, back in a few. At halftime here in the ASU Invitational, San Jose State and UC Santa Barbara.
Every Thursday at 4:30 p.m.
Bro, football season's over, fantasy football season's over. Can we even do Factor Fantasy anymore?
What if we just become like the number one sports betting show on all of Blaze Radio?
I do like me some sports betting and some money. Let's get this bread.
That's right. Tune in every Saturday from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. for the best sports betting advice you can find with Austin Scott, Danny Stepanovich, and Ethan Briggs on Blaze Radio. Tune in.
Do you want a sports show that doesn't want to bore you with the numbers and the stats and actually give real hard opinions and have good debate? Well, that's East Coast Bias. That's on Blaze Radio every Monday morning from 10:30 to 11:30, hosted by yours truly, Dylan Pescatore. And although it's called East Coast Bias, we go from the south, the west, the north, the east, whatever compass direction you want, wherever sports are happening, we cover it. And that's every single Monday, 10:30 to 11:30 on Blaze Radio.
Do you like everything paranormal? Are you a fan of spooky stories?
Tune into BlazeRadioOnline.com every Wednesday at 11 p.m. and join Grace Del Pizzo and Alexandra Zerborg as we host
Demon Hours!
Don't forget to follow us on Twitter at Demon Hours ASU.
See you there.
Demon Hours, Demon Hours, Demon Hours.
Whether it's a classic.
We all go a little mad sometimes.
Really gory.
Hello. Do you want to play a game?
Or even the one that questions your sanity. There's always a space for you to love horror movies. So tune in to Death by Film on Tuesdays at 3:30 p.m. on BlazeRadioOnline.com, which is hosted by me, Jordan, your horror movie guide.
This is Edward Van Halen.
Hi, I'm Jerry Garcia.
Hi, I'm Stevie Nicks.
Hey, I'm Vince Neil.
What up, dudes? I'm Tommy Lee.
And we're Motley Crue.
Hello, out there. This is George Harrison.
David Lee Roth from Van Halen here.
Hi, it's me, the great and powerful Cher.
Hi, I'm Anna Snow. And my name may not be as familiar to you as all of those rock stars, but if you like them, you should tune in to Currently Spinning Thursdays at 2:30 on Blaze Radio on BlazeRadioOnline.com. Don't forget to tune in and rock on.
Welcome to 4 on 4, where we have four experts on the four major sports. Join Sammy Newt, Dylan Wickman, Justin DeHaas, and Sean Brennan on Blaze Radio as they break down an exciting semester of sports that includes the beginning of hockey and basketball, the heart of the NFL and college football seasons, the MLB playoffs, and much more. At the end of the day, we're just four roommates that love to talk sports, so join the conversation. Listen live on BlazeRadioOnline.com every Friday at noon, or, if you missed us, check us out on Spotify, where you can hear all of our shows.
To all who come to this happy place, welcome. If you're looking for intellectual debates on Marvel topics, you may be in the wrong place.
Jesus, when I bought Marvel, I didn't think three guys were going to make a stupid podcast about it.
That's right. It's time for Agents of Blaze. Every Sunday at 8:30 p.m. on BlazeRadioOnline.com.
I mean, come on! How hard is it to come up with a real podcast idea these days?
Welcome, true believers.
Welcome back here in Tempe. Aiden and Blake, excited to be with you here on Blaze TV. On Pac-12 Plus a little bit later on. ASU will play in our final game of the day, but for now, UCSB and San Jose State all knotted up, about ready for second half action. We'll take a look at that Sunday slate. Four more games coming up tomorrow, Blake. We'll see all four of these teams back in action. Ottawa, San Jose State, then UCSB Marist, then Ottawa ASU, and San Jose State versus Marist to close out the day. Should be a fun conclusion.
Yeah, super excited for it, really excited for that UCSB and Marist one. That's probably going to be the best game tomorrow, and Marist, SJSU, Marist, no slouch. That this program could walk away with a couple of wins, and they are going to be on the upset trail against ASU just after this.
Who needs the Super Bowl, right? Right?
We got water polo on Blaze TV. Can't beat this.
Some have called this the Super Bowl of water polo. It's playing like that. We've seen a fun little game here so far, and
we've got a good old-fashioned slugfest right now.
Oh yes,
2-2, battling it out.
We love to see these two teams. After all they've been through, this is their, what'll this be, their seventh quarter of play. I got the math right there. Each of these teams will be playing in their seventh quarter of action today. A collision right around mid-pool as we get going again in the third quarter here on Blaze TV. Our final game of the day, reminder, ASU and Marist should be an interesting one. We're very intrigued to see how this Marist team matches up with the Sun Devils. That's available on the Sun Devil Water Polo Twitter. and of course on Pac-12 Plus.
I'm more intrigued to see how this game plays out right now, though. We got
absolutely.
We got a doozy.
We have a good little finish to this one. Remember, the first half ended with a penalty shot stood up by Don Levy. She's been an animal in net today. UCSB is moving right to left as we go here in the second, or in the third quarter rather, the second half. Fleming fouled. Works it over, only five to shoot. Macon Pardon, gotta get rid of it. They just loft it in and give the ball up. Again, that hasn't happened a lot. It's a little strange given how strong the defenses have been. The offenses have been able to get shots. The defenses and the two goalies in specific are really just getting the stops. Here's McKay on the attack for Santa Barbara. Under seven to play in the third quarter. Worked over to the far side. Halverson lobs it in, and another takeaway. This time Tatiana Raffin goes out and gets it. Locked it up. Here comes Kelsey Mathies. Rather, that's Anderson Viella. Working inside Plotz. She's fouled. The centering feed and a quick shot. You like the creativity there from Pardon getting the shot off rapidly, but oh, Don Levy was ready for it.
I like that quick ball movement from San Jose State. We see that strategy implemented by Marist, and they accumulated 20 goals, so maybe you have to take a page out of the Red Fox's book.
Let's keep it rolling here. Offensive possession for UCSB, down to five to shoot. The lob inside, the shot just off. Lee Leiter had a good look, but missed it a little wide to the right of the net. Under 6 minutes left in the third quarter, and we still haven't seen a goal. This is very much like how the first quarter started, back and forth, with each team trading defensive blows. On attack, Anderson Palella turns it over. And now JoJo Shear leading the attack. JoJo fouled at mid-pool. It was a long outlet ahead. Someone trying to flash in. 10 to shoot inside, and a swarm of Spartans are there to stop it. San Jose State just continues to match UCSB possession for possession. Here's Pardon, throws it to the referee. That was dangerously close to us, Blake.
Watch out.
I wasn't ready for that.
Watch your lips.
Action resumed. Thrown back into the pool. You'd think they could do that a little more gentle. Instead of just letting it thud against the water. ASU starting to warm up for their final match behind us. A little tough task with Marist. They face two high-quality opponents today. UC Santa Barbara makes a substitution. Into the game comes Emily Ferguson. And the Gauchos back on attack. Lofted up for Annie Kuster. Kuster moving forward. Works it over for Aiden Flynn. Playing catch. Flynn has it back. Rather, that's Emily Ferguson. Now rotated up. A shot just high. That's Aiden Flynn. Good look. The shots nowhere near the net for either of these teams.
Well, the defense has just been so good, making it so difficult, forcing shots from range, winding the shot clock down. And look at that. There's no breathing room.
4:11 to play. Foul inside. We're going back the other way.
Under control of the ball.
3:56 to go. Back and forth we go. Neither team has gotten any kind of momentum offensively, though. I don't know how that's any different than, you know, the rest of the game.
That's a little splash.
We got a little splash. Here comes Plotz leading the charge for the Spartans.
Seems like the San Jose is opening up a little bit here.
Another turnover. Nobody can seem to get any kind of momentum.
Well, it seems like both teams are kind of slowing up and haven't been able to develop a transition because of this roll of penalties lately here in this third quarter. And the transition is where we've seen most of the scoring throughout the day, not just this match.
Looking in front, Annie Kuster. They called out Shooter. Oh, she almost hit it. Wide left. 3:14 to go. Timeout taken by San Jose State. 3:14 left. Lake, I mean, time continues to tick. Someone's got to pull away here.
It's just going to be a matter of moments. It's what sports are. It's going to be who's going to be able to find the way to capitalize on the right opportunity and be able to set up their offense, be able to crack through these crackling defenses.
One goal could make the difference in this matchup. You start to get the feeling about
that. The
margins
are razor thin.
Absolutely.
And both of these teams need a win for sure. UCSB, let's recognize though, UCSB has not lost to a non-top 11 team this year. SJSU sitting at number 19. So I would expect UCSB to turn on the burners. There's a reason why they are ranked higher than the Spartans at the time.
14 to play in a 2-2 ball game. In the third quarter, Aiden Blank and Blake Neiman. Oh, we're right on time today, at least according to our wonderful friends at Sun Devil Athletics. And a good chance for us to thank them for having us out here today. This was a lot of fun.
It's been great fun. And we've got one more in store where the Sun Devils look to finish off perfect on the day. Continue their successful weekend at their host tournament, but it's been a nice change. Start of the day, pouring down rain. We saw steam coming up from the pool, but now we got clear skies and a little bit of sunshine too.
Thanks to SDA, again, Zach Wargo, the amazing brand new SID of women's water polo. Jaden and Parker coming on to hang out. They'll be back with you tomorrow. Thanks to the folks at Pac-12 Network. Helping us out and putting those ASU games all over the place, Blake. We were famous.
Yeah, it's the athletes that count, though. That's right.
That's true. These athletes have certainly given it their all. It's been a very entertaining game to watch. Game number four of the day. Again, ASU and Marist coming up later. Not available on YouTube. It is only available the Sun Devil Water Polo Twitter and available on Pac-12.com on Pac-12 Plus.
We see coming out of these breaks, teams find their advantage. Nearly won there.
Two-handed save, turned away, Don Levy.
One of the best offensive opportunities as of late. That was one-on-one, just a matter of who was going to win that matchup. And there Don Levy got it.
If you remember, this is right around the time that San Jose State changed goalies in game number one. Roffin was subbed out. Harry Haran came in. Went for about 3 to 5 minutes before finally subbed out. Three to shoot. UCSB's got to go. Lift, fire, save made. Roffin the brick wall. At this point, the question is, who can sneak it by a goalie first? .213 to go, approaching the 122nd mark. Don Levy at the controls. Towards the corner. Looking for somebody. Clock ticking down to 10, an overpass. Loose ball, and it's picked up by the Spartans. At this point, nobody's even getting good looks, Blake. The shots just aren't even coming.
Yeah, it's tough. It's tough to crack through these defenses, man. They are so good.
35 mark. ASU Invitational game number 4 coming up. Our final game later. Oh, this is going to help. Off the foul. San Jose State just missed it. Skipping wide, Spark, another great look.
Yeah, she literally missed that. Inches to the left. Nearly slipped inside, just outside the post.
1:13 to play towards the corner. Shot clock starting to wind. Christina Mullane. There's a shot and another one rings the bell. Emily Ferguson finds iron. 53 left. Shot clock still on. Approaching 40 seconds to play. Six to shoot. And a deflected ball goes up on top of the net.
Drew Halverson in there to deflect it, batting that one away. Again, she has water polo in her blood. Dad played water polo at Long Beach State. These are very experienced water polo players out there today.
About a 3-second difference between the shot and game clock. Whistle with 15 to shoot, 18 to play. Quarter number 3. Looking for help, dancing out on the perimeter. Bounced, and she eats water. That'll do it. The third quarter comes to an end, and boy, are we gonna see a fun quarter, Blake. Not a single goal in that third quarter. We are gonna see an excellent fourth.
What a finish coming up here on Blaze TV.
Let's take a break. We're back in a bit for the final quarter of action.
Tune in to The Waiver Wire, co-hosted by Logan Brown and Ruben Porras, who provide weekly fantasy football breakdowns, analysis, and so much more.
Touchdown! Remarkable!
Catch The Waiver Wire live every Tuesday at 7 p.m. Arizona time on Blaze Radio.
Broadcasting live on Blaze Radio, this is News of the World.
We are an international news show that highlights and breaks down all the biggest events happening around the globe. We go beyond the headlines to map out the bigger picture of world news.
On at 7 p.m. every Friday, only on Blaze Radio.
Hey guys, it's Nicholas Petrisky from Park the Bus.
Park the bus! What? Park the bus!
If you want to know what's going on in the world of U.S. soccer and the world of soccer in general,
have we got a show for you.
Come check out Park the Bus with me, Nicholas Petrisky, Alex McDonald, and Ethan Schwager all the way in Italy. Fridays from 3 to 4 p.m. on BlazeRadioOnline.com.
Hello, friends. Is golf your groove?
Then boy, do we have a show for you.
Join Peter Bishop, Owen Castle, and Ian Lonergan every Tuesday from 3:30 to 4 on The Bag Room for your fix of golf's latest news and a little bit of fun.
Listen in at BlazeRadioOnline.com, and if you miss a show, feel free to catch up on Spotify on our channel, The Bag Room.
Welcome to The Voyage. I'm your host, Pacey Smith-Garcia. Join me as we travel the world in search of incredible music and venture into some of its more obscure sides. We will hear the sounds of classical fusion in South Africa, the dream pop of Japan, and so much more. Join me on The Voyage on Sundays at 1 p.m. only on Blaze Radio.
Come one, come all, dear listeners, and gather around the Tavern Hearth for stories and legends from the magical land of Faerun. Join me, your host, Anion Fack McDaniels, every week as we delve into the vast lore behind the world of Dungeons & Dragons on Traveler's Guide to Faerun. Every Thursday at 7 p.m., only on Blaze Radio.
Oh, we're coming right down to the wire here at Mona Plummer in game number four of the ASU Invitational. Sun Devils are coming up later on, but they're waiting because we got a good one between UCSB and San Jose State. A clean sheet, the third, Blake.
Both of these goalies are just fantastic.
Oh, man.
They're fantastic. Ava Donlevy and Raffin, they've been holding off everybody, and someone's got to find a way to develop penetration and a look inside. No one's really been able to even get closer to that. There's been a couple of shot opportunities that have gone off the crossbar. We'll see who took advantage of the break.
Approaching 10 to shoot on the first possession for San Jose State. Now at 10 to shoot. Neither team scored a goal in 8 minutes of third quarter action. A shot deflected and into the seats. Feels like every possession is just kind of going to continue to build and build and build.
You can see the tension building. Both coaches over in their corners, hunched over, head in their palms.
Seven, 10 to play. Oh, another one ripped just wide. Drew Halverson, great look. The looks are starting to get a little bit better. This defense on both ends is starting to buckle. Santa Barbara needs to try and take the lead here. They have not led this entire game. Here's JoJo Shear. Work to Halverson. Shear at the point. 13 to shoot. Lobbed inside and taken away. The Spartan defense back at it. Here we go again. Another chance for San Jose State to take the lead. Their second possession of the half. Stripped from behind. What a stop.
The intensity is arriving.
Lighter. It's the first time we've seen that all day. She came in and took it right away. Retrieved by Halverson. Moving up. Feeds off for Juju Amaral. Into the corner. Shear looking to trigger. Amaral at the top of the point. Feeds over for Flynn. Oh, and another stab on net. Ruffin does her job. Under 6 minutes to go. Coming right down to it at Mona Plummer Aquatic Center. Number 12 UCSB, number 19 San Jose State.
Sorella Kay and Beth Harberts each hunched over in their chairs. Nervously watching on.
Another takeaway, long outlet in front. Is this the chance that they've been waiting for? Transition for Santa Barbara. Fires and scores! JoJo Shear breaks the deadlock. The first goal of the second half and the first lead of the day for the Gauchos at 3-2.
Well, hold up a second. Beth Harberts is furious. She is complaining like crazy. We saw a goal taken away earlier in this game.
That goal was from San Jose State. This would be from Santa Barbara. They have no signs of taking it away.
Beth Harbert still bickering at her team.
The two referees are on opposite ends of the pool, and one was kind of just looking at the other.
And it will stand.
It will stand. So for the first time today, the Spartans play from behind. Played up for Jenny Azorio. Spartans have had the better offense, or at least did coming in. Able to hang with ASU through a good amount of that game. Fed off for Plotz. They're going on an exclusion here. They send McKay off. A power play for San Jose. Down by a point. in their final game of Saturday here at the ASU Invite. A shot, they score! We're tied at 3, 4:46 to play. Lucy Majewski puts it home. The Spartans trailed for all of, half a minute before they come back and get a power play goal to tie us at 3.
That was a fabulous setup by Plotz. Coming here on the near corner, throws it to the far side. It drew Don Levy over to the far side of the net and then able to shoot it back to the backside into the four hole.
Back the other way we go. Approaching 4.5 to play. The offense is starting to pick up as the defense is buckle late. Looking for help. Back to the top with Mullane. Christine Mullane harassed out at point. We're going to get a foul. Off the resumption, a loft inside. It ends up on the top of the net. Aiden Flynn. We'll reset with 4:10 to go. More great defense. Tight, tight, tight from the Gauchos. You got a feeling both of these teams will bring that late. Lofted inside. She got the step. All alone. And the score! 2-1 answered. And San Jose State regains the lead at 4-3.
No goals at all in that third period. We've had 3 in the last 3 minutes.
Under 4 to play.
Back and forth. Now the sucker punches are really being thrown.
San Jose State entered at 1-3. They're now 1-4. Boy, would they love a ranked win here over the 12th team in the country. UCSB looking for their 8th of the season and their 2nd of the day after their loss in the opener yesterday to ASU. Fed up ahead. First time in this half that Santa Barbara plays from behind. 15 to trigger, lofted inside and taken down. Azorio and Majewski combined to stop it. Clock ticks to 3.5 minutes. Off a foul, Santa Barbara playing defense. They have not trailed by multiple goals all afternoon. Here's Macon Pardon. Working hard. Pardon trying to get free. Pardon gets free. And a foul. San Jose State is going back to the power play on the other side of this timeout. And once again, Beth Harberts has gone over to talk to the official.
I think she's arguing for exclusion here. It looks like it got
absolutely
a hold of her throat. And I think there should have been a penalty called.
You could see that the tight defense that was played here, she was held underwater. She couldn't get to the ball.
Yeah.
Let's step aside. 3:11 to play. And a 4-3 lead for San Jose State. Coming back on the other side of it here on Blaze TV.
Park the bus.
If you want to know what's going on in the world of U.S. soccer, and the world of soccer in general,
have we got a show for you.
Come check out Park the Bus with me, Nicholas Petrisky, Alex McDonald, and Ethan Schwager, all the way in Italy. Fridays from 3 to 4 p.m. on blazeradioonline.com.
So here they are, the best group in the universe, musician for musician, the dynamic, electronic, Grateful Dead.
I agree. They are the best group in the universe. And if you also agree, or even if you don't, you should tune into my show, Back from the Dead, every Monday night at 8 p.m., only on Blaze Radio, on blazeradioonline.com. Peace and love, everyone. Jam with you on Monday.
Welcome back here on Blaze TV. The Sun Devils waiting to play in the final game of the day. We've got ourselves a great finish here between San Jose State and UCSB. Off the resumption, another goal. And that one, Blake, feels like a dagger.
I don't know about that, Aiden. I wouldn't speak too soon. UCSB could really climb back in this thing.
Two-goal lead for San Jose State for the first time today. Under 3 minutes left. We're in for a fun finish. We're glad to have you with us here on Blaze.
Camilla McKay is swimming out. It looks like it's still a power play after that exclusion call. So
yep.
I think it was a major penalty is what we saw. And San Jose State took advantage.
Yeah, quickly. You were right. You were right. She was being choked before we went to break. Over for Amaral. Juju lost it in deep. And a turnover. UCSB is going to need a call here. They got to go back on defense. They've surrendered goals on their last two possessions. Thrown in. Here's Azorio. This battle has been so fun to watch right near us. That's what the major penalty resulted in. Such a physical matchup thrown away as the shot clock expires. 2:14 left. Santa Barbara needs a goal here to get back within one.
Yeah, and I think that's why Sorella Kay just burned a timeout trying to reset her team. Need a strong push here in the closing minutes here. And we've seen the physicality. San Jose State not even using it. They've had their game plan. And we've seen Beth Harbert's been advocating for her squad all day long, showing a heart symbol to her squad. Don't know if that's either a scheme set or just showing the love for her team.
2:14 to go in a game that saw no goals in the third quarter. We've seen a couple to start the fourth. 5-3 in favor of San Jose State. We still have another, arguably maybe even more entertaining matchup. We'll see. With
it's
Arizona State Mariners coming
this
up.
But San Jose State, it's their first multi-goal lead today. First multi-goal lead for either side. We saw them jump out the gates early and get that early lead, but UC Santa Barbara really controlled the middle part of the game and seemed to have the momentum swing. But then Beth Herbert, with a great timeout, was able to burn it and get her team. And that penalty on the near side, major penalty, took two players out of the game for UC Santa Barbara. And that was a major power play opportunity that the Spartans just simply couldn't miss on.
You're looking at a San Jose State team that's 1-4 at this point. But, I mean, you can't get a better opportunity than this early in the season. To come here and battle a top 15 program in UC Santa Barbara. To battle them right down to the wire here.
Yeah, 1-4 over the last five.
Look at the teams that you're going to have to play in MPSF action. This is a great preparation for that. Off the resumption, Flynn has it, lifts, and she's fouled. Flynn gets it back. Lofted inside. Absolutely gobbled by the Spartan defense, who has really started to take over. Under 2 minutes left. Near side. Here's Spark. Spark is fouled. One thing you can't do here if you're UCSB is allow an exclusion. Gotta get rid of it, and they do. Very clear there that San Jose State just wanted to burn the clock. And a timeout before we can resume action. Let's take another break with a great one going on here at Mona Plummer. 5-3 in favor of San Jose State.
White's got a 30 left.
He did what? He is Houdini! What a play!
Tune in to The Waiver Wire, co-hosted by Logan Brown and Ruben Porras, who provide weekly fantasy football breakdowns, analysis, and so much more.
Touchdown!
Catch the Waiver Wire live every Tuesday at 7 p.m. Arizona time on Blaze Radio.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you tired of listening to the same pop music in your car? Are you excited to branch out into other genres of music that you've never heard before? But most importantly, do you recognize this song? Or this song? What about this song? If you answered yes to any of the previous questions, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Well, not really. What you can do is tune in to HAWT.
Wednesdays at 1:30.
Only on Blaze Radio.
Back here in Tempe, Aiden Blank and Blake Neiman. Great to be with you on Blaze TV. The ASU Water Polo Invitational, and we've had ourselves a fun one. But Santa Barbara getting into crunch time. Just over 60 seconds left. Needs a score.
They need a score right now.
Cross pool pass. Gonna have to strike from long range. Stopped in front of the net, and that may do it.
It's like a swinging gates out in front of the net. Just continuing to serve as windmills, disrupting everything in sight.
55 seconds left. Are you looking over it? Sun Devil State or Mountain America Stadium, as you were saying that. 43 seconds left. Santa Barbara needs a prayer here to try and get out of this. We'll get another timeout. Each team had a 30.
Yeah, so that is going to be Beth Harbert's and San Jose State's last timeout. Want to make sure nothing goes wrong over these final 43 seconds, but this would be a huge win for San Jose State. This would snap their four-game losing streak, be their first win in quite some time. And for UC Santa Barbara, this would be a setback in the sense that the only other teams they'd lost to were in the top 11. And it all came down to that penalty. That penalty really swayed the momentum of the game and just shows how crucial people are physical throughout the game, but the turning point was really in that major excursion.
It's become a beautiful day here in Tempe, Arizona, with the Devils waiting somewhere around here. They're starting their warm-ups. We'll get a good one to finish out. We'll see if it's better than this one. I don't know that much can top the finish that we've seen between these two teams. The physicality, both of them in their second game, the physicality they've exhibited.
I've been very impressed with both sides' physicality, and especially UC Santa Barbara with their defense. But San Jose State, I mean, we've seen some pursuits from behind to be able to force some steals. And just the velocity on some of these shots has been impeccable. And most certainly, arguably the biggest, most physical players have been the goalies in net and Don Levy and Raffin.
Tossed back in. Here we go, a foul right near midpool. At this point, you're probably going to see a lot of that. Santa Barbara has no choice with just over 30 seconds left. They throw it away, and here we go. UCSB with 35 seconds left. Going to have to go super fast. Down by two goals. Hucked up across the pool. Timeout before that. Or at least that's what was signaled. It is a timeout.
And that's the last.
Neither team wants to go to their bench. But it was a timeout. They're going to have to reset it here. Right near midpool. 30-second mark in the ballgame. 5-3 in favor of San Jose State. Can't take this long. Got to go. 20 seconds. Looking for help. Has to let it go, and it's just high. As good a look as you're going to get there, but that may just set it. With 18 seconds left, that may just set things up for San Jose State to break that losing streak. What a hard-fought battle.
Both sides, but a very deserving and hard-fought victory for San Jose State.
The Spartans gonna break a four-game losing skid here. They battled tough with ASU, couldn't quite seal the deal, but they're able to do it here. 5-3 the final. The Spartans take out the Gauchos.
What a great display of water polo out there today. It was really both sides, anyone's game going into that fourth quarter after a scoreless third. But then ultimately in the end, we saw San Jose State take advantage of a UC Santa Barbara mistake. Physicality, emotions were high, intensity was building, but UC Santa Barbara unable to come away with the win and suffer the loss after going up with a W today. They fall to 1-2, and then San Jose State, they split their Saturday slate.
One more battle coming up in the final game of the day, ASU and Marist. We'll step aside and be back in roughly 15 minutes with that final game again, available on Pac-12 Plus, not on our Blaze TV channel. So for our producer, Jaden Taylor, and Parker Porrell on the camera, my partner, Blake Demon, I'm Aiden Blank saying so long. We'll talk to you in a bit for ASU and Marist.
What's up, Blaze Radio? I'm Kat Michalak.
And I'm Raina Majolet, and we are your hosts for Track Diggers, bringing you underground golden hits.
If you guys are looking for new music to listen to and maybe